Hello friends, I am Rahul and today we shall discuss about rebirth. As you know that I have made video for you, difference between Buddhism and Hinduism, and I have told you 5 things about difference between Buddhism and Hinduism. So many person has given suggestion for me and many person has commented on my video. So I wanna give thank you for you. Thanks for commenting your thanks for responding my video. I had discussed on the video about rebirth and soul. So I have told you difference between soul. So Hinduism trust on soul, but Buddhism do not trust on soul. But I have and next about rebirth. So I have told you there is same Hinduism trust on rebirth and Buddhism trust on rebirth. But how is it possible without soul? Is it possible that rebirth? So I have told you yes, it is possible, and I had told for you that I shall tell you next video. So I have brought for this video about is it possible rebirth without soul. So I want to take reference Buddha and his Dhamma. This book has written by Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, and this is very good book. So it is very complicated case. So that's why I have bring for this book. I shall tell about in this book it is possible rebirth without soul. So if you have not watched my video before, so please watch my video. If you have not subscribed my channel, so please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. So let's go on Buddha and his Dhamma. Thanks for coming mobile screen Buddha and his Dhamma. For clear, is it possible without soul rebirth? I am giving the reference Buddha and his Dhamma book. Actually it will be complicated to explaining you, so I have thought that I should tell you on the Buddha and his Dhamma book. We shall read together and we shall understand is it possible without soul, is it possible rebirth. This book is on www.columbia.education, and for the information, this book is taught Columbia University of New York, Buddha and his Dhamma. This is very famous book of the Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, and in India people consider that holy book of Buddhism. So let's read. Rebirth of what? First, did the Buddha believe on rebirth? The answer is in the affirmative. It is better to split this question further into two parts: rebirth of what and rebirth of whom. It is better to take each of these two questions separately. Here we may consider the first, rebirth what. The question is almost always ignored because of the mixing of two questions that so much confusion has arisen. According to Buddha, there are 4 elements of exist which go to compose in the body. They are prithvi, ap, tej, and vayu. If you talk about in the English, so earth, air, and fire and water, there are 4 elements. Buddha considered that the 4 elements compose in the body. Question is, when the human body dies, what happen these 4 elements? Do they die along with dead body? Some say that do they. The Buddha said no, they join the mass of similar element floating in Akash space. When the 4 elements from floating mass join together, new birth takes place. This is what the Buddha meant of rebirth. So it has been clear that which type Buddha believe on rebirth without soul, and of course it is possible without soul. So I hope it will be clear that which type Buddha trust on the rebirth and without earth, without soul, it is possible rebirth. So what do you think about this video? You can tell me in comment box. And if you want to read this book, Buddha and His Dhamma, so I have told you, you can go in the Columbia University of New York. And this book is original. Dr. Osam Ambedkar has written on Buddha and His Dhamma. And this book is holy book, people consider it in India. So what do you think about this video? What do you think about rebirth? So you can tell me in comment box. And if you understand that this video is useful for you, so please share this video. And my request that please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. Thanks for watching.